In Europe, we hardly have any mulberry trees anymore. It was different in the past, but let's see what effect this plant has. You'll find a link below where you can download a free PDF about the health effects from mulberry tree, also called Morus. Mulberry trees grew all over the world. The leaves were used as food for silkworms. This is the only thing that silkworms eat. Since we hardly use silk anymore, these trees have disappeared. In Italy, there are a whole bunch of plantations. Today, practically no such trees exist anymore. The trees are now only found in Far East Asia, in China, Vietnam, and Laos. There you can still find large plantations because silk is still harvested there. Mulberry leaves have played a major role in Chinese medicine for 5,000 years. It was practically used as a remedy for fever and cough. The leaves contain about 15 to 25% proteins and are therefore a fantastic source of protein. Vitamins and minerals are not the focus here. However, there are a very special substance found in these leaves. It's called deoxynojirimycin. Try repeating that. This active ingredient is unique. No other plant in the world has this substance in its leaves. And this substance has medicinal effects. First, in the gut. An enzyme that breaks down sugars multiple times is slowed down. Second, it prevents the binding of glucose and hemoglobin. This means that less sugar is transported around the body. And third, it promotes insulin-producing cells in the pancreas. Can you see where I'm going with this? It is a wonderful remedy for diabetes. We have a threefold effect. Similar to a drug that lowers blood sugar levels, I see great results with it. Before I gave a diabetes patient a drug, I recommend to try Morus capsules. It almost always works, and you can postpone more severe treatment for a long period of time. Of course, alongside a change of diet. The dose is quite simple. One capsule of Morus with each meal.